afternoon, Cheryl.
Good afternoon, Edison.
It's nice to be here in February today. Change of environment, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really lovely to be here. It's such a privilege for us to be here. So thank you very much for inviting us. We're quite happy to be here in fellowship with you.
Is this quiet?
We're really, really happy.
Are you happy to be with us today?
Okay, thank you for that. Before we start, one of my friends here is telling me to say thank you for the wonderful lives that we had.
Yeah, it's quite a warm welcome since we arrived here. Somebody's welcoming us at the park and car park and then just around there. So it's really great of you to welcome us here.
And this is quite a program. We would like to introduce ourselves. We are called the musicians with a mission. And that mission can be is based on Matthew 28, verses 19 and 20. It says, "Go ye therefore, teach all nations, baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. In the law, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world."
Today, brothers and sisters, our mission is to help every one of us to lead you into a higher level of praise. We pray that the songs that we will be singing and playing will lead us into worship of God, the one who is worthy of all of this, right?
Missionaries, it's a compound word, musicians and missionaries. So we're not just playing music, but we'd like to impart the message as well.
Before we start again, we would like to introduce one of our instruments. It's called angklung. This instrument is made up of bamboo. And it has three pipes.
Right. Tubes.
It has three tubes, and the higher and the bigger the instrument is, the lower the note, and the smaller the instrument is, the higher that sound.
Okay.
And this instrument,
you want a sample? Okay. Yes. All right.
And the word from Indonesia, this is the instrument.
So each one of these bamboos will only produce one note. So it needs teamwork to produce a harmony. Yeah, so that's how important teamwork is in spreading out the gospel.
Okay, without further ado, we'd like to request Anthony to lead us into a meditation. To help us prepare for this program. And this will be followed by Pastor Gary for our opening prayer.
Thank you. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you. Thank you that we can be here this afternoon, Lord. Thank you that you brought us all here safely. And Lord, we give you praise for that. We thank you for bringing these wonderful musicians to us also, Lord. And Father, we often think that as we hear music like this, what it must have sounded like for you when David played on his harp. Father, you've gifted these people with the gift of music, and you've given them wonderful talents in this area. So Lord, as we listen to this music this afternoon, may it be another form of worship as we glorify you. So Father, may your spirit be with us in a special way and keep us attentive to what you're saying to us this afternoon through this music. And we thank you in Jesus' loving name.
Our program this afternoon is divided into four parts. I hope you have all your a copy of your program. The first part of our program is entitled The Birth of Jesus. And the second part is focused on the life of Jesus Christ. And the third part?
The third part is about the third angel's message, about worship and judgment. And the last or the culminating part will be about the second coming of Jesus Christ.
Okay, so we're now on the first part of our program. And again, this is the birth, about the birth of Jesus. What month are we now?
October.
And yeah, November, and it will be Christmas. In the Philippines.
December.
Yeah.
December.
In the Philippines, the start of Christmas season is September. So when you go to the Philippines on September, you can see the streets all lined up with the Christmas
decorations. Yeah, there will be lots of lanterns, and there will also be firecrackers being sold, and also gift wrappers, and here and there, and people start to buy presents already by this stage.
But is that the real essence of Christmas? We don't believe that December 25 is the birth of Jesus, right? But
no, not really.
Is that the real essence of having a Christmas season? The gift and all this? No.
Highly unlikely. I think the essence of Christmas is more on remembering the birth of Christ. That God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have an eternal life. So birth of Jesus, that's just a great symbol of his love for us.
I'd like to add a verse to that. It's Isaiah 7 verse 14. It says, therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel. We'll be playing two songs which are entitled What Child Is This and O Come All You Faithful, and this will be played by the anthem, strings and flute.
Thank you.
love is boundless. His love is everywhere. His love is free. I can't think of anything sweeter than God's love. Our next number is a choir item, and it's entitled, Oh, the Deep, Deep Love of Jesus.
Underneath me, all around me,
That was a nice song, isn't it? The message of the song was really, really good. Can we say the last phrase of the song? It was, "Hallelujah, God is love." Can we say that all together?
Hallelujah, God is love.
God is love. God is love. And one of the manifestations of God's love to us is the birth of His Son, Jesus Christ. And there are times we forget the story of this birth of Jesus, of our Savior. Oftentimes we focus more on the gifts, the festivity of December 25, but we sometimes forget that was one of the most wonderful things that happened on earth, is the birth of Jesus Christ. Let me ask you a question. What is your favorite Christmas song in a hymnal?
Joy to the World.
Yeah. There are heaps of classic songs that really tells the story of God's amazing love. And now we're going to play those two classic songs. Songs that have never been forgotten, and we keep on playing, and even though we play them repeatedly, the meaning is still there. And those are "Hark the Herald Angels Sing" and "Silent Night," and it will be played where unplugged are strings and flute. May we all be blessed with these songs.
Thank you.
was the first part. I hope you enjoyed that so far.
What's your favorite song of those music we played?
I have to say, I really like, personally like, "Oh, the Deep, Deep Love of Jesus." I do. And all the others are really great as well. Okay. Now, the second part is the life of Jesus Christ is an example of how we will live on earth. So when Jesus Christ was here on earth, how did he live his life?
How? I think Jesus lived his life full of love.
Full of love, yes. Yeah. He was a teacher, he was a friend, he was a comforter. Was he not?
Yeah, he was. And in everything that he did, he touched it with love.
Yes, indeed. So Christ, when he was here on earth, he was perfect. And why do you think he lived a perfect life, even though he was here as a human being?
For us to follow, is that right? Is that right?
Yeah, he should set that example. But how was he able to do that?
What do you think, Fun Great Church? Why do you think Jesus lived such a perfect life?
I heard some beautiful answer here.
Connection with the Father. Connection with the Father.
Okay.
Yeah.
He had a connection with the Father.
Connection with the Father?
I think that's the right answer. That's the answer we were looking for. Mm-hmm. He was in constant connection with the Father. So this second part, our songs are mostly songs, a pair of songs, but making that connection with God. Because if we establish that connection, then we will be able to live a perfect life.
Yeah.
Right. So as part of our things that we do as musicians, we are relatively young. We were just yeah. All of us are. We'll always be young at heart. But yeah. We're just young in the sense that we have just been recently formed.
We will always be a child to God.
Yes, because we are His children. Yeah. So we meet on Fridays. We worship together. Do our vespers together. And we do our practice, but we also study the Word of God through, as of the moment, we are doing the storicals. So this is part of our self-study, because we have to know the word through our hearts, wholeheartedly. It should be inculcated in our hearts and minds, so that we would be able to spread the Word.
Amen. Okay. So we'll be playing "Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing" and "Thanks to Be to God." This will be played by Anthony, a violin solo, and the second song will be played by Anthony, Nikki, and our flutist. May we reflect the message of these songs, and I think it will be flashed on the screen.
Thank you. So while we are arranging ourselves, I just say something about this. Our next songs will be Ride the Morning Winds, Lead Me Lord, and this will be followed by the prayer and Anchoring and Strings item. So Ride the Morning Winds talks about how God is everywhere. No matter where we go, God is there. And Lead Me Lord is a song composed by Filipino artists which asks for guidance. So it's all of the three items are prayer songs asking for guidance.
You are love. I really praise God for those two music that we played. The last song that we sang was Lead Me, Lord. And that truly is my prayer in my life. Most of us here are young people, and living in an urbanized country has different trials. And since we started this song, I think a lot of us created this song as our theme song in life. A prayer, indeed, that we may be led by God. Our next song that we're going to play is another prayer. And I know prayer is central to our Christian life. Without prayer, where we will be. Without prayer, our faith will not grow. Am I right? I invite everyone to meditate on the message of this song as we play the prayer.
Thank you.
now come. We've now come to part three.
The third part of our program, which is focus on the third angel's message. I'd like to read a verse from Revelation 15. It says, "And I saw another sign in heaven, great and marvelous, seven angels having the seven last plagues for him. Last plagues, for in them is filled up." Oh, I think I'm in the wrong verse. Okay. Let us open our Bible in Revelation 14. Yep. I don't know what happened to my phone. It's Revelation 14, verse 6. And it says here, "And I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on the earth, and to every nation and kindred and tongue and people, saying with a loud voice, Fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment is come, and worship him that made heaven and earth and the sea and the fountains of waters." I think this verse is very relevant to all of us. This verse is telling every one of us here in this church that we have a mission. And we and missionaries believe in this mission. We are part of this group, not just to play. I can honestly say that I enjoy playing with music with these people. But when you go back to the real essence, you feel that I am called. God has given me something that can be used for his mission.
I agree. So although music is a passion, but it does not end in just playing instruments and just singing songs, but we have to also spread the gospel, and we can do this. How do we do this?
Okay.
We cannot go to the go out without being equipped ourselves, eh?
Yeah.
Yes.
And this is what I'm thankful to God, because we, all of us here, are students. Every Sabbath afternoon or every Friday afternoon, we are taught by our elders. Thank you for our elders. Who are our elders? Yeah. They guide us young people to how to give Bible study, how to relate in this world, which is full of worldly things, right?
So we have in our missionaries group, we have subdivided ourselves into small groups. And each small group has a support person. So the support person are more experienced. And this support person, they guide us, and they're able to share their experiences with us so that we will not be misguided and we will not be lured by the world. Instead, we should be set as examples to the other young people that in what we do, in worshiping Christ and in doing good, they may be also see the light in us.
Okay.
So our third part is about prayer, it's about worship, and it's about getting ourselves prepared for the judgment day. And the first part is called my tribute, because this is how we thank God for his goodness.
Everyone. Yes. Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Happy Sabbath. I don't like speaking in front. That's why my back is always turned like that. I seldom speak in front. All our musicians here, they've just started. Just like, for example, the cello players, they've just started around 2 months ago. Our flutist, she just started around a month ago. And they were being taught by our friend here, Anthony. Toby just started as well, same with Kiel. Chris, he just got back into playing, and we've been pushing him. Now, one of our members decided to study the piano. It's not part of the program, but I want him to share what he learned in the past couple of weeks. So before Nikki plays my tribute, I'm going to ask Lars to accompany Nikki in playing Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
next song will be Sangre Choir's entitled Worthy of Glory. This song is a testament that God is indeed worthy of all our praise, that for what He has done to all of us, we need to give back all the glory to Him, isn't it? Do you believe that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, in this song, we are saying that God is worthy of glory, for He has redeemed us with the blood of the Lamb, and He has set my spirit free. So, you can sing with us if you know the song, and if you don't, just sing with your thoughts. Life that is full of service to God. May I give now the
the floor to Anthony for his violin solo. And this will be followed by Anglong strings and flute.
Thank you.
can you say? Thank you. And could we just show our appreciation to these people with a big amen and also clapping, please? You know, these folks have come up to Whangarei today on their own accord, and they've financed it all themselves, and I'm just so proud that I can call these people my brothers and sisters. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And thank you. Yeah, come on, give it another go, guys. And it's nice to see that they've glorified God today in this wonderful way of presenting the plan of salvation in music. Thank you, team. And you know, they're real professionals, because do you realize they're wearing this beautiful beautiful costume this afternoon? Do you remember what they were wearing this morning? What color was it?
Blue.
Blue jackets for the ladies and their long dresses. The men, black trousers and beautiful blue ties. So again, they're professionals, amen? And so what else can I say? But a big thank you to you all, and Dyden and Errol and this young man here for creating such a wonderful team of musicians. Not only are they musicians, but they're also fantastic vocalists. And it just shows you that all things are possible through Jesus Christ when you can learn to play an instrument in 2 months. There's chance for me yet. But we've got another three songs, but I'd just like to express our sincere thanks for what they've done for us today. Amen.
Now come to our culminating part, the second coming of Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ is coming again. Is that the good news?
Yes.
Indeed.
I think that's great news. So this, if you summarize the Bible, what can we say? We can say that it's a story of love. It's a story of redemption. We are redeemed, and therefore we've got the hope that He will be coming again to take us all to the kingdom of heaven.
You know what, I can't, after hearing Sister Diane speak this morning, I can't wait to see that 2,400 kilometer square, yeah? Yes. I can't wait to see that big city. Yeah, I can't wait to live there. In behalf of the Auckland International Seventh-day Adventist Church missionaries, I would like to thank every one of you for inviting us and for sharing our faith, for sharing this music, and for sharing this opportunity to worship our God. It feels like this is what we're going to see in heaven when we all go there. Amen?
Amen.
We will all be singing praises to God. Amen to that?
Amen.
Would you like to sing continuously?
Sure.
Well, if you like to go to heaven, I don't mind being your neighbor there. I'm really excited and looking forward to all those beautiful gems, but the most wonderful gem is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So before we end, let me share the word of Jesus Christ through John 14 verses 2 and 3. So I'll give you some time to open your Bibles so we can all read it out together as practice, because in heaven we will also be doing lots of stuff, singing and telling beautiful stories. So first, so John 14, verses 2 to 3. Verse 2, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you.
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may also.
Amen.
So this is our prayer.
Thank you. Well, that was the music in Aries, and fantastic. Thank you very much. And wow, when are you coming back again? I'd just like, in closing, just to ask the musicians that once I've finished with the prayer, if you could just all file out into the foyer so we can all personally thank you. Is that okay? All right. Please be upstanding for prayer. Dearest Heavenly Father, this afternoon, Lord, we have all heard again through praise and worship that you are the great I am. Heavenly Father, we're just so thankful that you are coming to take us home soon. You have prepared a place for us, Lord. You've got a mansion ready for each and every one of us, Lord. Help us to accept that wonderful invitation, that gift of salvation so freely offered to each and every one of us, Lord. Help us now to take it to our families and friends so that they can be with us, and even if they're our neighbours in heaven, praise the Lord. But Lord, we know that you've got this beautiful Jerusalem ready for us, Lord, and that one day we'll be all in it to come and settle back down on the earth. Father, we thank you for this great love. We thank you for each and every one of us here, and we thank you for the musicians, Lord. We just ask that you'll bring every one of us safely home today, especially the musicians, as they've travelled from Auckland today. We've got members from Kaikohe and other parts of the north. So please, Lord, bring everyone home. But may your spirit guide us and quicken us, Lord, as well as comfort us. And knowing that no matter what happens in the future, you are there with us every day of our lives. Thank you, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.